You know that coworker who somehow functions perfectly on 6 hours of sleep while you're dragging yourself through the day after eight? There's actually a scientific reason for this. The Japanese have known this secret for centuries, and it has nothing to do with genetics. In Japan, sleeping less isn't about grinding harder or pushing through exhaustion. It's about something completely counterintuitive. They actually honor sleep by doing less of it. Picture this. Business people napping on trains, students dozing in libraries, employees catching quick rests at their desks. In the West, we'd call this lazy. In Japan, it's called inemuri, and it's a sign you're working so hard that sleep finds you anywhere. Here's where it gets interesting. The average Japanese person sleeps just 6.5 hours per night, yet they live longer and report higher energy levels than Americans, averaging 7.5 hours. It's like they've discovered the sleep equivalent of compound interest. They're not sleeping less because they have to. They're sleeping less because they've learned how to sleep better. Think about your own sleep. You probably treat it like a bank account, trying to deposit as many hours as possible. But what if sleep is more like exercise? Quality reps beat quantity every time. The Japanese approach, sleep like a martial art, with discipline, technique, and respect for the process. Chapter 1. The 90-minute secret. Your brain doesn't count hours, it counts cycles. This completely rewrites the rules of how you should approach sleep. Every night, your brain runs through 90-minute sequences like a washing machine. Light sleep, deep sleep, REM sleep, repeat. Here's the part that'll make you rethink your alarm clock. Waking up after 6 hours means 4 complete cycles. But 8 hours? That's 5 cycles plus 30 minutes of interrupted chaos. You're literally waking up mid-spin cycle, which is why you feel like you've been hit by a truck despite sleeping longer. Think of it this way. It's like watching a movie and leaving during the climax versus waiting for the credits. Your brain hates unfinished business. When you wake at 7.5 or 9 hours, completing 5 or 6 full cycles, you're getting up at a natural transition point. Your brain is ready. Your body's prepared. The funniest part? We've all experienced this accidentally. Remember that time you overslept but felt amazing? You probably hit exactly 6 cycles. 9 hours? Or those days you had to wake up super early but felt surprisingly good? 4 cycles. 6 hours. Exactly. Chapter 2, quality over quantity. Here's something that'll mess with your head. The person sleeping 6 quality hours gets more deep sleep than someone tossing and turning for 8. It's not about time in bed. It's about time and actual restorative sleep. Japanese sleep culture focuses on something called sleep efficiency, the percentage of time in bed actually spent sleeping. Most Americans have 70% efficiency. The Japanese? They aim for 95%. Do the math. 6 hours at 95% efficiency equals 5.7 hours of actual sleep. 8 hours at 70%? Only 5.6 hours. You're literally sleeping less by sleeping more. The secret is treating your bedroom like a sacred space. No phones, no TV, no work. Your brain needs to know bed equals sleep, period. It's like trying to work in a nightclub. Sure, you could do it, but why make it harder? And here's the kicker. When you optimize for quality, quantity becomes irrelevant. Your body gets what it needs faster, like downloading files on fiber internet versus dial-up. Same content, fraction of the time. Chapter 3, the perfect bedroom. Your bedroom is probably 5 degrees too warm. The Japanese keep their sleeping spaces between 16 to 18 degrees Celsius. That's 60 to 64 Fahrenheit. And yes, that feels cold at first. Here's why this matters more than you think. Your body temperature needs to drop 1 to 2 degrees to initiate deep sleep. A warm room is like trying to hibernate in a sauna. Your body fights the environment instead of relaxing into it. The minimalist approach isn't just aesthetic, it's functional. Every object in your room is a potential distraction. The Japanese futon isn't just about saving space. That firm surface, It maintains spinal alignment, the low height, better air circulation. Plus, making your bed literally disappears your sleep space during the day. And forget those blackout curtains that turn your room into a cave. You want darkness at night, but natural light in the morning. The Japanese use lighter curtains that block enough light to sleep, but allow sunrise to naturally wake them. It's like having a 6-million-year-old alarm clock built into the planet. Chapter 4. The Sacred Evening Ritual. The last hour before bed determines the quality of the next six. The Japanese don't just go to bed. They perform a ritual that signals every cell in their body that sleep is coming. It starts with the ofuro, the hot bath. But here's the trick everyone misses. You're not relaxing in the bath. You're preparing for the cooling after. That post-bath temperature drop mimics the natural cooling that triggers sleep. It's basically hacking your circadian rhythm with hot water. Then comes the mental transition. You can't go from 100 miles per hour to sleep. The Japanese practice what they call ma, purposeful pause. No screens, no stimulation, just gentle stretching. Perhaps some tea, maybe journaling. It's like gradually dimming your mental lights. The funny thing about bedtime routines, we have them for kids, but abandon them as adults. Then we wonder why kids sleep better. The brain craves predictability. Same time, same sequence, same outcome. Your routine becomes a Pavlovian trigger for sleep. Chapter 5. Mastering Sleep Cycles. Set your alarm for 6, 7.5, or 9 hours, never 7 or 8. This simple change will transform your mornings more than any expensive mattress or supplement ever could. Here's how to calculate your perfect wake time. Add 15 minutes to fall asleep, then count in 90-minute increments. Bedtime at 11 p.m. Set your alarm for 5:15 a.m. or 6:45 a.m. Never 6 a.m., that's mid-cycle disaster territory. The power nap follows the same rules. 20 minutes catches you before deep sleep. Go longer and you need the full 90 minutes. That 45-minute nap that leaves you groggy, you're waking up during deep sleep, the worst possible time. It's like rebooting your computer mid-update. What about those nights you can't control bedtime? Always sacrifice quantity for cycle completion. Better to sleep 4.5 hours than 5. Better 6 than 7. Your brain will thank you with clarity instead of punishing you with fog. Join our YouTube membership for exclusive perks like early access to scripts, input on future topics about productivity, and connect with a like-minded community that gets it. Click join below and let's build your easier, more intentional life together. Chapter 6. The Art of Inemuri. In Japan, napping at work shows dedication, not laziness. Inemuri literally means present while sleeping. You're so committed that your body rests while your spirit remains engaged. The key to strategic napping isn't just duration, it's timing. Your body has a natural dip between 1 and 3 p.m. Fighting this is like swimming against the current. A 20-minute nap here equals an hour of night sleep in terms of cognitive restoration. Here's the part that'll change how you see productivity. NASA found that pilots who napped 26 minutes improved performance by 34%. That's better ROI than any productivity app or time management system. You're literally sleeping your way to better output. The social acceptance matters more than you think. When napping is shameful, people push through exhaustion. The Japanese remove this stigma, making rest a tool rather than a weakness. Imagine if your office had nap pods instead of ping pong tables. Chapter 7. Morning Energy Activation. The first 30 minutes after waking determine your energy for the entire day. The Japanese have this down to a science, and it starts before you even open your eyes. First rule, no snooze button. Ever. Snoozing fragments your sleep cycles and confuses your brain. It's like starting your car, turning it off, starting it again, you're flooding the engine. When that alarm goes off at your cycle completion time, get up. Sunlight is your secret weapon. 10 minutes of morning sun provides more alertness than a double espresso. The Japanese practice asahi, greeting the morning sun. It's not spiritual mumbo jumbo. It's circadian rhythm activation. Your brain has photoreceptors that only respond to morning light wavelengths. Before coffee, water. Before breakfast, movement. Your body is literally dehydrated and stiff from hours of stillness. 5 minutes of stretching and a full glass of water will wake you up faster than hitting yourself with a caffeine sledgehammer. Coffee is for enhancement, not resuscitation. Chapter 8. The food-sleep connection. What you eat for breakfast affects how you sleep tonight. The Japanese have known this for centuries. Your morning meal sets your sleep hormones for the entire day. Protein in the morning provides tryptophan, which converts to melatonin by evening. It's like planting sleep seeds that bloom 14 hours later. Skip breakfast, and you're asking your brain to produce sleep hormones from nothing. Here's the timing trick nobody talks about. Stop eating 3 hours before bed. Stop drinking 2 hours before. Your digestive system needs to power down too. Late night snacks are like asking your stomach to work the night shift while your brain tries to clock out. The Japanese approach to evening eating is brilliant. Light, warm, easy to digest. Miso soup, not pizza. Rice, not pasta. Your grandmother was right about warm milk. It actually works. The calcium and magnesium promote muscle relaxation, while the warmth triggers that temperature drop afterward. Chapter 9. Common mistakes. You're probably making three critical errors without knowing it. These mistakes sabotage even the best sleep intentions. First, weekend sleep-ins. Sleeping until noon on Saturday is like flying to Tokyo every weekend. Your circadian rhythm doesn't understand weekends. The Japanese maintain consistent wake times. Yes, even on Sunday. Your body rewards consistency with energy. Second, the pre-bed scroll. That quick check of your phone suppresses melatonin for 90 minutes. It's not just the blue light. It's the mental stimulation. Your brain can't differentiate between a work email and a tiger attack. Both trigger fight or flight responses. Third, treating tired as normal. If you need caffeine to function, you're not sleeping properly. The Japanese view chronic fatigue as a system error, not a personality trait. Being tired isn't a badge of honor. It's a check engine light. Chapter 10, your new sleep life. Tomorrow morning, you'll wake up different, not because of magic, but because you now understand sleep like the Japanese do. As a skill to master, not time to waste, start with one change tonight. Drop your bedroom temperature and calculate your wake time in 90-minute cycles. Feel the difference tomorrow. Then add the morning sunlight. Then the evening ritual. Build your sleep system brick by brick. The real transformation isn't just sleeping less. It's living more. 6 hours of optimized sleep gives you 2 extra hours every day. That's 730 hours per year. An entire month of extra life every year, just from sleeping smarter. Remember, the Japanese haven't discovered a genetic advantage or secret supplement. They've simply respected sleep enough to understand it. Quality over quantity, cycles over hours, efficiency over duration. Your perfect sleep is waiting, not in another pill or product, but in the wisdom of aligning with your body's natural rhythms. Tonight, you don't just go to bed. You begin your journey to Japanese sleep mastery. And tomorrow? Tomorrow you wake up fresh. And hey, if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe and hit that like button. Also, let me know your thoughts on what I just shared. Oh, and there's more. I've just started a Patreon to help support these videos and connect with you more directly. Check out the link in the description if you'd like to join.